$6,430.
Oh my gosh.
Now a lot more leh.
Correct. So the moral of my story is buy your Chanel bags now. Correct. kidding. We hope you have had a good CNY break so far. What about you girls?
Not as much money as last year. Didn't manage to see as many relatives.
Uh-huh. Oh yes, yes, that's right, that's right.
You're married.
Yeah, this is good for me. The cap of 8 is very good for me.
Hey, really, this is the topic that we are going to be unpacking today. Mm. Money.
Wow.
Money. Success, right? I mean, does money equate to success? Okay, we'll cover that in just a bit.
Yep.
But today, we are going to talk about another topic related to finance, but mostly about our careers. What does success really mean to us? Because we know some people chase after monetary success, but some people see prizes of recognition like success.
Okay.
Star awards maybe.
Oh. Hey, on that note.
Yes.
Our dear Hazel, we are also proud of her because
so proud.
Her radio show has been nominated for a Star Award.
Yay!
Thank you for your support.
And it's the only solo show. Exactly. The rest of them have like 2 people, 3 people, 4 people.
And she's the youngest.
Exactly.
So everyone please vote for her.
请帮他投票。我们非常热烈。Thank you.
Okay. Get your speech ready, huh?
Yeah. Wow, my speech. I think Hush Podcast will be the only people listening to the speech.
Producer Anne can write for you.
Correct.
Her scripting is very good.
Correct. Hey, you know they have like the red carpet and then like the fence stand by the fence?
Yeah.
We go, Ken.
Okay.
We hold her picture.
Okay.
Okay, which picture, huh?
All.
Okay, moving on. Okay, so this is a form of success as well to some people, right? Prizes of recognition, awards, medals, promotions. And other people see success as a journey. What does success mean to you?
Wow.
Germaine.
When I think of success, I actually think of my dad. Because he's successful in his own right and he came from nothing. He came from a family with 14 children.
Wow.
Struggling
Oh my
goodness. Struggling to eat, struggling to make money.
Wow.
And he came from literally rags to riches. So I always think success is being a business owner because that's how he found his success.
Uncle, I want to meet you.
How? Okay, what about you, Azura?
I think this is a little bit, maybe it's not as popular an answer. And I think maybe people would be like, sure not, say only lah.
No, but we want to hear it.
I honestly believe in it. I will tell you that I just want to be happy.
Then I think you're really successful. Like that,
like, yeah.
Because suddenly a lot of images of Azura just flash by in my head. And 10 out of 10 times, right? She's smiling in my head. Leh.
Yes!
She's laughing. Stop laughing, Azura!
Wait, you hit her!
Luxury goods.
Okay, our favorite.
Yeah.
We talk a lot about it.
Not like 1-ply or 3-ply tissues, but bags that cost thousands of dollars.
Jewelry.
Does that mean you are successful if you can own these bags?
I think that is one form of success. Monetary success.
My answer is yes as well. But okay, Azura, why don't you think so?
I don't see it as... If you like it, you can afford it, and you want to buy it, sure. You know? But I don't think anybody who, let's say, doesn't have it should look at it and feel like, oh, I'm less. Or, oh.
For sure.
Only until I have that, then I'm successful. Yeah. So I feel like there's nothing wrong with it. I mean, I cannot say there's anything wrong with it because I love it too, right? But okay, my principle when it comes to luxury goods is that I don't think you should be starving for it.
For sure.
Yeah.
Not in debt for it.
Yeah. Absolutely not. Yeah. It should be spare change.
Yes.
It should be...
within your means.
Exactly. Exactly. I don't think you should be like... putting aside more than half of your earnings just to save up for it, you know? I don't think it should happen like that. If you do that, that's your choice. That's okay. As long as, you know, you're comfortable, you're not starving, you're not, like, in debt. But I do think that it's not... I don't tie material goods to success. Although I know it's a form of, you know... it's like a benchmark for people, right?
Yeah, or like being able to afford a Birkin bag. Like that is, you know, people look at you differently.
Yes.
Like, oh, you must be successful to be able to afford a $15,000 bag at the least.
Yeah.
Sorry,
actually, I have something to say about that.
Oh, but, I thought you were going to say, I have a Birkin
bag.
Yeah! I was like, can I borrow? If you're listening, it's about time. Anyway.
But what about you, Germaine? I mean, we all know that you come from a very well-to-do family.
Oh.
Do you think luxury bags or luxury goods mean that you are successful?
Actually, before she says anything, right, I just want to say that I've thought about this for a while. Okay. I'm very, very impressed with how her parents brought her up.
I am as well.
Especially, right, a couple of weeks ago when she said, I don't think this was on air, but I remember we had a conversation about, you know, coming from a comfortable background, and something Germaine said stuck out to me, which was, but it's not my money, it's their money. And I felt, right, like, wow, their parents really did something right. Because I have tons of these friends, right? And are you all saying? And it's very rare that you hear something like that.
To be able to differentiate what you earn exactly. and what your family earns.
Exactly,
right?
Because a lot of them are like, it's mine, law.
Yeah. My parents,
well
law.
Done, yeah. Lem. Mommy, Mama,
you,
and
Papa
Germaine. There we go.
To me, when I bought my first luxury bag, it was a Chanel boy.
Of course.
Which I brought today.
You brought today!
Show it! I'm so extra.
Show it!
I'm gonna show it to you guys!
Yay!
You know how much this means to me? I even remember the date I got it.
Oh my god!
2018, 4th of May.
Wow.
I bought it in the MBS store, Chanel, and it just hits different, you know what I mean?
Right. Because it's almost hard-earned money.
Yeah. And for sentimental reasons, I don't think I'll ever sell this bag, lah. But
wow.
Look at this.
Head on to our Instagram
to have a look at
Hazelle's Chanel bag.
Very nice.
Can you tell us how much it was?
Sure. I remember.
Okay.
$6,430 for this Chanel boy.
I think now
caviar skin. Small.
Oh my god.
Now a lot more leh.
Yeah, correct. So the moral of my story is buy your Chanel bags now.
Correct.
kidding.
Honestly, I feel like while a lot of people, you know, they want to be happy, but I think in that pursuit of happiness, right, it takes a lot of courage.
Mm.
It takes a lot of courage to say, this is not working out for me, I'm done.
Okay.
Because a lot of people don't have that courage to cut out things that are not working out for them.
Mm-hmm.
Either they feel responsible for it, or they feel like they have no way out of it.
Or they feel like they can't do better than it.
Exactly.
Mm.
I think it's important to acknowledge as well that success comes in like a variety of forms and whatever it may be for you, right? I hope you don't let people influence your choices.
Yes.
Because if that's your truth, that's your truth.
Mm.
If that's what you want, that's what you want. If that keeps you happy, that keeps you happy. But I think a lot of us still sort of take into consideration what people will think, you know, with regards to like luxury goods. Maybe some people do it because they feel like, oh, it makes them look better or it makes them look successful. No point lah. I mean, there's no point if you carry a $1,000 wallet but you have nothing inside, right? I'd rather carry a $1 wallet and like have $1,000 inside.
That is very, very true.